Good afternoon from Okinawa, Japan, home of OkiSubies. We got a little interesting tech tip for you guys. What happened was, some of you may know, although videos aren't released yet, but we have rear-wheel drived the EZ30 Turbo Legacy. The problem with it is we keep breaking things and we have to fix things, and those videos haven't come out yet because we haven't gotten that final conclusion. But here is the transfer gear completely snapped off, right? Which is, even without the EZ30 setup, people are also doing that in the rear-wheel drive community. It's just kind of one thing that happens. It's a point of failure besides the drive shafts. So what I did was, after this broke, I contacted a company and I ordered a really nice billet setup, the dog gear. This is actually for like the PPG 6-speed setup. You can actually order just the back portion and it will fit inside of the 6-speed that doesn't even have the PPG front gears and everything. You can still utilize it. So I asked this company, because they listed it 2000 to 2005 transfer gear kit. So I said, that's a little bit weird, but let me just verify. Hey, I have a viscous style non-DCCD 6-speed from a Bug Eye STI. Is this the right link? And they said, yes. I ordered it. And I have my car over there jacked up and everything, right? So I went to go pull it apart. And as I pull it apart, I noticed that this is my Watanabe center diff. And it will obviously not work, right? Because this is the transfer gear. This is how it works. So to kind of backtrack and explain a little bit, this is the rear, the transfer case portion, right? It goes on the back side. This connects there, this portion connects here, and you have a center diff that is connecting the rest of the front end of the transmission, okay? This part right here is different than the aftermarket. So I know that's a little bit hard to follow along. That's just kind of an update right there. A lot of you guys may actually be watching because of the thumbnail. Can you convert a non-DCCD to a DCCD? What does this have to do with that? Well, it has everything to do with it, because in my research on trying to figure out how I can utilize this gear, it ends up being that answer. Can you do it, right? So the part that I got, I showed the company and I showed them, hey, this is the OEM viscous style. It doesn't fit. I showed them that. And then I actually have a DCCD 6-speed here that I pulled apart, and I showed them that it does fit inside of a DCCD setup. So it is not for a non-DCCD. It would be great if I could just send this back and get the proper stuff for my application. Unfortunately, there's not a company that sells them. If you look at all of them, whether it's IAG or a few other companies, they're always the DCCD, like 04 to 06, and then you have the 06 and up. And what they're talking about with the transfer gears, right? It's a 1-to-1, right? A 1-to-1 or a 1.1-to-1 difference in the new ones. But without getting too detailed into that, how do you do it then? Can it be done? Well, looking at it, let's take a look here. The front portion of this and this, right? This is a very important portion. Will the DCCD center diff even slide into the non-DCCD transmission like so? And as you can see, it will. The funny thing about it is the actual, everything is the exact same, in the sense that, look at this portion right here. You see this? For a non-DCCD, it is actually, it's pointless to have it. But that's actually the portion where you flap open and you put the connector in and you hold it in for the connector. This is the non-DCCD 6-speed, by the way. And it has everything that you need on the inside already. If you look over here, the difference is the wiring comes in this portion. So you would have to first, step number one, to convert it from a non-DCCD to a DCCD, you'd have to drill a hole and purchase this wiring, which is the 6-pin versus the 4-pin, right? So the non-DCCD has a connector here, which is only the reverse lights and neutral position sensor. For a DCCD setup, you have two extra ones that also control the center diff. So you would need to connect or purchase this The opposite side would need to be connected to something like map DCCD or DCCD Pro, but purchasing this connector, I already called Subaru for you guys who are wondering, and you can purchase this separately. It's like, over here it was like 5,000 yen, like 50 bucks or so. So you can purchase that. So what I ended up having to do, this is the Watanabe center diff to make it rear wheel drive. This is also a Watanabe center diff. To make this work, I had to spend another, like Q Mayan, like 800 bucks to get this DCCD center diff. And check it out. The front ends are the exact same, right? Looking at it this way, you can't even tell which one is for the DCCD or the non-DCCD. It's just when you get to the back, right? So when you get to the back, this is the billet setup. It fits. So now I'll be able to put this in like so, right? The difference is this is going to be on the back side. So when you start tearing it apart, I'm trying to find what's different. So besides the connector here, the front end is the same, the back end is different. So to get it, to make it happen, you have to get the connector. You have to obviously purchase a DCCD center diff. And then you have to purchase the back transfer gear. This part. This is the part, this is the OEM one to the DCCD. And this is the one to the non-DCCD. This is the only part that's different. And as you look at the aftermarket one, it is the same to this one. It's just the teeth are different. It's a little bit more beefy, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the DCCD transfer gears into my transmission using the DCCD center diff. And I'm going to be able to utilize this setup. With that working, you can literally put everything together to make it a DCCD transmission. Which is, I asked that question because I had a Forester STI and it was non-DCCD. Do I have to purchase a whole nother transmission versus just making a DCCD? So I understand the desire to do it. My honest opinion is still sell your non-DCCD 6-speed and buy a DCCD 6-speed. Because to drill that hole and whatnot. But if you wanted to go this route, because these parts sold separately are still expensive, so at the end of the day, I don't know if you're going to be saving that much money, but I've looked at all the bearings. These are the new ones. I ordered all these from a DCCD Subaru bin plate that we had from Subaru, and matching them all up and measuring everything, they're all the same. The final thing is there's shims that go in between the transfer gear and the center diff. And the funny thing is, look at this, is a piece that holds this portion so it doesn't move. Look, even on the bug eye stuff, the non-DCZ stuff, it's still there. Everything is literally the same when it comes to the casings. But there's a little shim here that you do have to. So technically you're supposed to have like a little block. You measure here, you have another block, and you're measuring to the top of the DCCD setup, and there's specific shims that you need to get and whatnot. So I'll try to attach some pictures on the Subaru manual on how to do that. For me, I'm not even gonna put them in because it's just floating in there anyways. And I don't wanna take these shims off of this 6-speed that we're gonna end up using, honestly. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this all together and put it back in my car and be able to finally drive it.
Do burnouts.